That's what happens when your AC clutch locks up. So you're running without an alternator hooked up. Barely made it here last night. Thing was catching on fire. All right, well, started morning with my addiction. Took my radio out because that thing pulls power for whatever reason. Shut my fridge off. Shut off the GPS. No light usage. This is where our voltage is sitting. And we're gonna see how far we make it. As long as I don't shut the truck off, I should be okay. Because this truck is minimalistically electric, if that's even the word. It doesn't need a lot of electricity to run, as long as your lights are not on. There's not a lot of sensors or anything. So we'll see how far we can make it. Sounds nice. Can't see from down there.
Turn left onto Ohio 78 West.
That thing sounds sick. It's that cat power, baby. Or even a regular cop. Yeah, that was pretty rough. Like, try to minimize usage of turn signals. And when I opened my hood, that compressor was literally like throwing sparks everywhere. Good thing my belt didn't break and went into my fan and my freaking other belt. That would have been bad. So the only things on that belt is the AC and the alternator. Water pump is inside the gears. So, you know, technically if I had a belt that's small enough for the alternator and the gear driver, that would have been enough. But, you know, I don't.
Here we are, stop number 6, and then one more in Ohio, and then in Ohio I'm gonna get a new compressor and clutch. As long as I don't shut the truck off, I should be okay, and it's cleared out a little bit. So yeah, let's get loaded and get going. Well, we gotta make a turn here. It's a sweet Jeep. Someone's gonna get cut off. Appreciate that, man. Driver right there. Yep, came that way down to 77. You're gonna have to roll back there, buddy.
Continue on rail and drive for 3/4 of a mile.
Poor lady. Back up. It's like 10 minutes faster if I go via routes, but it's like 20 miles less or so, but I'm gonna go up on 77, take a longer route. I like highways better than routes, especially routes in these neck of the woods. Yeah. pride. So we're at the receiver, got a clutch, getting emptied out, $100 for the clutch. The reason I'm not replacing the compressor and the clutch, because I think the bearings on the clutch just went out, which made it go crazy, because AC wasn't even on and it screwed itself up. I think the AC is fine. If it is, I'll go back and buy the AC, but it's pretty simple. This is the clutch. It's held by this big bolt right here, just right here, and it spins freely on its housing. And then whenever the AC is turned on, the magnet grabs that and spins the whole AC compressor itself. So pretty simple, just 4 bolts here, 1 bolt here, easier than the compressor. Hopefully we get loaded here fairly quick. Got my AC running on my generator. I'm gonna move to a truck stop and yeah, I think that should do it for the day. This is my current voltage. It's sitting at like 11 and a half ish or so. Definitely low. So yeah, go truck stop and hopefully I don't need a jump, but in case I do, I will have somebody to jump it there for me. That's the thought process behind it at least. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. It's definitely been another stressful day. Things break, unfortunately, so it is what it is. But yeah, kind of wait here, get unloaded. They are unloading pretty quick, feels like. And catch y'all in the next one. Thanks for watching, y'all.